Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. In this video, we're going to be solving a practice question on risk and return. Now, what you can do is click on the link in the description to download the worksheet, pause the video, try to solve it yourself, and then watch me go through it. Now, before we get started, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel as it is the best way to support me and my desire to bring high quality, easy to consume tutorials to you at no cost. Okay, let's check it out. So here you're given a situation where you've got two stocks, stocks A and B, three different possible states in the economy. High growth, moderate growth, and recession. You're given the probabilities for each one and what the expected returns for the stocks are in each of those states. The first question you're asked is, find the expected return for each stock. So to do that for stock A, so we're looking for the expected return, we're going to take the probability and multiply it by the expected return in each individual state. So that would be the 25% probability of stock A returning 40%, 20% probability of stock A returning 20%, and a 55% probability of stock A losing 10%. And that works out to be an 8.5% expected return. For stock B, we'll do exactly the same thing. A 25% probability of earning 55%, a 20% probability of earning 25%, and a 55% probability of losing 20%. And that works out to be 7.8%. Now, the second question, you're asked to find the standard deviation of each stock. So for this, we're going to need the expected return from the previous question and to use it in this formula. So to find the standard deviation for stock A, we have to do a big square root, otherwise you're finding the variance. The first probability of 25% multiplied by the return, so 40, minus the expected return, 8.5, squared. And now I'm going to repeat this for each state. The next probability is 20%, 20 minus the expected squared, and 55% probability, negative 10 minus 8.5 squared. And that should give you a standard deviation of about 21.51%. I'll do the exact same thing for B. So big square root, 0.25%. Now B would earn 55% in the high growth state minus the expected return of 7.8 squared, 20%. Times 25 minus 7.8 squared plus 55% times negative 20 minus 7.8 squared. That should give you 32.27%. Now I'm going to remind you that if you're not familiar with these formulas, to make sure you check out my other videos where I describe the concepts of expected returns, standard deviation, and so on. Question number three, you're asked to find the coefficient of variation. Now, to find the coefficient of variation for stock A, we're going to take the standard deviation of 21.51 and divide it by the expected return of 8.5. Multiply that by 100, and that gives me 253.1%. That is the amount of variation relative to my expected return, my risk relative to my return. Coefficient variation B, I'll take the standard deviation of 32.27 over the expected return of 7.8 times 100, and that is 416.4%. So you can see that stock B is a lot more risky than stock A is relative to their respective returns. Now, for the covariance and the correlation coefficient, we're going to use the covariance formula to begin. So we'll take the first probability of 0.25, multiply by stock A's return, which is 40, minus the expected return of 8.5. And then we'll multiply that by the exact same thing, but for stock B, right? Because for the covariance, we're trying to measure how they move in relation to each other. So I'll take 55, which is stock B's return, minus 7.8. And I'll repeat that for each state. So plus 0.2. Now stock A would be 20 minus 8.5. Stock B would be 25 minus 7.8. And then for the last one, 55% probability, stock A would lose 10% minus the expected. Stock B would lose 20% minus its expected. And that should give you a covariance of 0.069413. Or if you did it in percentages, 694.13%. A little interesting thing to note for the covariance. If you want to convert a covariance from a decimal to a percentage, you need to multiply it by 10,000 and not 100, which we're all kind of used to doing. So that's important. And if you want to go back from percentage to decimal, you divide by 10,000. Now for the correlation coefficient. To find the correlation coefficient between the two stocks, you need to take the covariance and divide it by the two standard deviations. So if we're going to do this in percentages, I'm going to take my percentage covariance, divide it by my two standard deviations. So 21.51% times 32.27%. And that'll give you a correlation coefficient of approximately 1. Now, it's not exactly 1 because of rounding, but it is actually 1 if we were to keep all of our decimals. So this tells me that the two stocks are perfectly positively correlated. They always go up and down at the same time. In the final question, you're asked to find the portfolio expected return and the portfolio standard deviation if you were to put 60% of your money in stock A and 40% of your money in stock B. So to find the expected return of the portfolio, I'm going to take the weighted average. So 60% of my money times the expected return of stock A, which was 8.5, plus 40% of my money times the expected return of stock B, which is 7.8. And that'll give you an expected return in your portfolio, or a weighted average, of 8.2%. And for the standard deviation, because the assets are perfectly positively correlated, then the easiest way to find the standard deviation of the portfolio is also by doing a weighted average. Now, it's important to note that you don't always do this, right? When they're not perfectly positively correlated, you would have to use a different formula. But when they are perfectly positively correlated, the standard deviation of the portfolio is the weighted average. So 60% times the standard deviation of stock A plus 40% times the standard deviation of stock B, and that gives you 25.81% as the standard deviation of the portfolio. Okay, everyone, that's it for this video. I hope that you were able to solve the questions correctly, and if you weren't, that you understood how to do it along the way. Please leave your questions in the comments if you have any. I'm happy to look over them. And if you found yourself struggling throughout that and you want to learn more, I'm also going to leave a link in the description to my Wise Prep Intro to Business Finance online course. There, you can learn the entire course chapter by chapter, step by step, while practicing questions and watching me do examples. I'll see you at the next video.